What is this? Give me a tube over here.
Give me my stethoscope.
We have no idea what we're dealing with. Trying to catheter, get fluids in him. I don't have a heart. Boom. Boom. All right, let's get a catheter in, because it's real slow, but it's there. One beat every 6 or 8 seconds, really slow. Can we find out, like, what it's not doing right, like how?
The dog has been falling over, vomiting, having diarrhea. That just started yesterday.
We're gonna need a PACBC. This gets to be too much. Pull that tube, put a mask on for oxygen.
It's when the heart stops. Like, that's the biggest single emergency that I worry about. But we can get tubes down and we can breathe for them. That's not an issue. As long as it has a heart, we're winning. When it doesn't have a heart, you gotta hustle.
Yeah, let's get a quick x-ray.
X-ray's dead.
Let's get the dog back over here on the table. I do think this is a lung-heart issue. His lungs are filling with fluid and he can't breathe. This is a 14-year-old dog. This is like doing something with your 90-year-old grandmother. I mean, we're limited to what we can do. All right, so do 20 milligrams of Lasix. I'm giving him a diuretic to help drain the fluid from his lungs. Well, definitely breathing better. Yeah, the heart's normal now. I'm hoping a few nights in oxygen cage is gonna make Chico breathe easier. The medications we have Chico on should help reduce the fluid in the chest and make the heart beat more efficiently. Well, there's definitely another problem. These medications are not cheap, and the owners really can't afford them. The situation with Chico is the two ladies live in a car.
My sister passed away 3 years ago after being in the hospital for 6 weeks and a day. We lost our home, we lost our friends, our family, everything. And now we have Chico and Diesel and each other, and that's it.
Well, you go up there and talk to the lady crying and tell her that you're not gonna do anything.
Grandpa's boy, aren't you? Yeah.
Animals bring joy, their unconditional love, and their companionship to these people's lives. And that may be the biggest thing in their life that they have going for them.
A lot of people just tell us it's a dog, it doesn't matter, but it's our family.
If they have money, maybe like a $1,500 deposit?
No, they have no. They have no money. They live in a car. Melody, she's my daughter. Melody's in charge of paying all the bills.
Money's stressful. He doesn't look at the money. He'll be like, are we good in the account? Yeah, okay, thanks. Like, that's the gist of his worrying about what we have and how I'm making payroll or how I'm paying the bills.
Melody's always that I don't charge enough money, you know? And I mean, I'm always hounded, we gotta make more money, we gotta make more money, and I'm the first person not to charge people. Bottom line, we're gonna do what we can to give Chico a decent life for however much longer he's gonna live.
Yeah, Chico, it's okay, bub.
Oh, that's
yeah.
Right.
Who knows, you know, if we can get the heart issue under control, it's possible this dog will go out and, you know, live for, you know, I'm not gonna say years, but potentially months anyway.
Chico will be kept at the clinic for the next few days so Dr. Jeff can keep an eye on his condition.
Chico passed late last night. I have to call the owners now. Yeah, is this Willem A? I don't have good news. I am sorry.
I know. You are. Thank you so hard for trying to keep him alive. Thank you.
You got to see him in a little bit better state, you know, versus when you brought him in. I'll be honest, you know, when I knew he was on a short rope, I was hoping, you know, maybe a few months, you know, maybe a half year, you just don't know. But he obviously was pretty darn stubborn because he tried to die before seeing you, and then he sees you, and then it's like, okay, I don't know, you know, there's some kind of phenomenon there, it's a weird thing. It's amazing to me because you see that a lot, animals that just, you know, they keep fighting back, and then once they get back into their owner's arms, they seem to die right away, and it's a fascinating phenomenon to me. I'll try to do my best for people who I know care about their animal, and you care about your animal. That's the main thing, okay? So that's real important. So I wish we could have done better by him, all right?
Dr. Jeff, I'm just thankful for you.
Well, I just brought him in because, he got kicked in the face by a horse.
By a horse?
Well, he got kicked in the eye.
In the eye?
Yeah.
Okay. And his name?
Nico.
All right, let me grab the doctor and I'll send her right in.
Well, I'm 26. Most people say I look like I'm 21 or something like that.
So what's going on with Nico?
It's tough. I'll walk into a room and I don't know how many times people ask me if I'm just a technician or, you know, a receptionist or something. And then I have to explain to them I'm actually the doctor, and sometimes they look a little bit worried about that. So it's kind of frustrating.
Injuries like Nico's are common in Colorado. When ranch dogs live with animals 30 times their size, accidents are bound to happen.
Oh yeah, I can see that eye. That one's really cloudy and red. And that was after he got kicked.
Yeah.
The eye it's got hemorrhage in it. It's also cloudy. And I can see the hole on the top there, right there. That looks like an ulcer. It looks pretty deep. The ulcer could be from the kick. It could be, you know, maybe he's been rubbing it or something, if it's hurting him, and he could have actually caused it. So we need to do what's called a fluorescein stain. The dye will soak into that ulcerated area and it'll glow. So we'll be able to see like how deep it is exactly. Good boy. There's a spot in the middle of the hole that isn't picking up the stain. So that means it's very deep. We'd have to take him to surgery to fix that. So human eyes, we don't have the third eyelid like many animals do. Dogs have it, cats have it. Having that extra membrane there is a perfect little flap that you can just pull right across the eye, and that just gives a nice little extra layer of protection for the eye to heal under.
So I'm gonna take a look. Worst case scenario, this dog would lose its eye. The ulcer would spread and get infected. So Amy, see if you can get a look down here. This is obviously not an aggressive ulcer, or it'd be a lot worse already. So we just put a needle suture through the third eyelid. We're gonna use a little tubing and something to tie to. I don't wanna get right along the edge, so I wanna come back a little bit, you know.
All right.
And then it's a matter of where you hook through the third eyelid. So I'm gonna come back on the other side. I go back and forth on these all the time. I can back stitch, but I really want a precise stitch with this. You can tie these a little bit tight and cause a little necrosis. Here's some hair loss. You don't want to do them too tight. You don't want to do them too loose. All right, so the next one you get to do. Yeah, go ahead.
With dozens of surgeries a day, Dr. Jeff's clinic is a great place for new vets to learn, or the first place rookies will fail.
If you don't have someone willing to teach you surgery and show you things, then you never do it. So I'm gonna have Amy finish off the procedure and fix the ulcer in Nico's eye.
Amy is sewing the third eyelid in place to protect Nico's eye while the ulcer heals on its own.
I was a little bit nervous, but that's okay.
Does that look good though? Is it too shallow?
I think it's too shallow.
Okay.
Amy's a rookie, and I think, you know, it took her a while to understand that third eyelid is not very thick, and you don't want suture rubbing the eyeball and making the ulcer actually worse or making a new ulcer. About to get it?
Well, yeah, but I don't like it. It's like.
All right, pull the whole thing back out and start over. Do one more. And take the whole thing out. Just pull it all out.
Pull it all the way through?
Yep, pull all the way through. One stitch, you can do it.
Jeff is a great mentor. He doesn't beat around the bush, and he explains things well.
So you gotta poke through, come down, hook this over here and pull it up.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
Sometimes it's hard to keep up with him. You know, you have to keep up and pay attention or you miss something.
Kind of hard, because I put the first stitch in, so I had the easier view of it. But it's pretty straightforward.
Stitch looks pretty good.
Yeah, it looks good. So go back up, tie it off, yep. Amy did a great job on Nico's eye. You can tell she's still a little nervous, and I don't know if it's because she doesn't have the experience or she knows I'm watching.
The third eyelid is completely covering his eye now, so looks like we did a good job.